Hi, everybody, and welcome to Ivy League Analytical English. I'm Karen.
And I'm Wesley.
Today is September 26th. I hope your new semester has gotten off to a good start. But it's time to keep working on your English over the radio. Our title of our composition based on pictures today is Too Good to be True.
好，那我们的中文标题跟英文标题没有什么关系啊。中文标题是蜡像馆惊魂记。
Well, they are related, but you have to read the whole story to figure out how they are related.
Yeah, 你要看的故事你才知道说哦，原来他们讲的是他们是有关联的。但是光就英文跟中文之间的关系来讲的话，这个英文的标题这几个字跟中文的标题这几个字是他们之间不是翻译的关系。
Yeah, they've taken a totally different approach. So, what do we have to do in today's exercise?
好，那今天我们的这个文章呢，提示部分告诉我们说要仔细观察以下三幅连环图片的内容，而且想象一下第四幅图片可能的发展，那写出一个涵盖连环图片内容而且有完整结局的故事。
Well, that was nice and short and sweet, short and to the point. So let's look at our next section.
好，那这个写作小寨部分呢，我们讲到这个看图作文呢，就是要叙述图片内容，所以你要琢磨于它的图中人物，它包括它的脸部表情啊、情绪啊、穿着啊、人物互动等等的。好，你要谈它的时间、地点，还有事件等等这些资讯的细节，你把它串起来描述一下啊，或者叙述一下。那一般呢，你可以把自己当做这个图里面的主角啊，那这个用第一人称来叙述。你也可以就一个旁观者的角度来看啊，给予图中的这些主角给他们一些姓名啊，然后呢，用第三人称的观点、旁观的观点来看这来讲这个内容。那不管是你第一人称还是第三人称。你都一定要用想象力用逻辑思考先构思出一个合理的剧情重点要分明有开头发展结尾那这样子才能够求故事连贯然后呢你要善用转折语来串联每一张图之间的关系这样才能够流畅的写出看图说故事那要注意不要天马行空跳跃式的叙述或者写些不相干的东西把它写进来跟故事发展没有关联的东西不要写进来好那此外呢随着故事发展你可以适度对图中人物的情绪啊多加以琢磨啊多加以琢磨那文章就会具有的更多的可看性跟更丰富的内容。
As you were speaking, I had a soundtrack running in my head of previous times that we have gone through the same instructions. We've done this for years and years and years, a few times every month.
Yeah.
So by now you should know the instructions if you're a regular listener. But if you've never paid attention,Make sure that you pay close attention this time and understand everything that they're telling you to watch out for. Because, you know, if you just kind of let it ride by and you never really listen to it, this happens a lot in life. Things that are repeated, our brain says, I've heard this before, I'm not paying attention. Well, maybe you never really paid attention even the first time. Make sure you do understand everything they're telling you to watch out for, because all of those points are important.
Yeah, 我们这个每一次讲到这种看图作文，我们都会把这个刚刚讲的那些讲一遍哈，那我们不厌其烦的讲，就是因为想说，有一些人可能是第一次听到，或者以前没有注意到这些啊，那还是要提醒你，写这种看图说话的时候，你要注意哪一些重点。
Okay, next is our 构思方向。
好，那我们检视图片之后呢，我们来叙述一下啊，这个打一个草稿啊，看看这个图片内容啊，剧情怎么样？所以我们可以想到说啊，可能是啊，在伦敦度假的时候呢，这个 Amy 跟 Tina 啊，他们决定要去参观一个。蜡像馆那看到的偶像啊 Robin Chan 啊
Is he a real person or did they make him up?
I'm not sure.
Because when I looked at it, it looked like maybe he's some popular singer right now, but I've never heard of him and it doesn't give his Chinese name.
Yeah.
If they had a Chinese name, we could check.
Yeah.
But if he's Cantonese, Chan is Chen, Erdong Chen. If he's Cantonese, so a lot of times these stars are from Hong Kong and they're using a Cantonese spelling. If he's from Taiwan, C-H-A-N is usually Zhan. So it could be two totally different family names.
Yeah.
And unless we know where he's from and unless they give us the Chinese characters, we really don't know which.
所以这个他看到了偶像这个 Robin, Zhan 或者是
Chen
的偶像的蜡像的时候呢他们两个人很兴奋就跟这个蜡像自拍。然后拍一拍之后呢这个后来再与他自拍然后查看照片的时候突然发现这个蜡像的姿势怎么不一样了那他们吓到这个有鬼就放声尖叫 结果呢，故事的结局是，原来那座蜡像是他本人啊。
Isn't that a surprise?
Yeah, 这个蛮有趣的啊。
When they write these stories, it's usually 老套。
Yeah.
It's usually stuff we've heard hundreds of times or thousands of times.
Yeah.
This one really surprised me.
Yeah, 所以这个蛮好玩，这个蛮 surprising 的哈。然后呢，这个他很亲切的也为这个啊 Amy 跟这个 Tina 来签名，而且邀请他们，哎，我们再来多拍几张合照吧。Yeah.
And that's unusual too. If you're really famous, you get sick and tired of fans asking for your autograph or asking for a picture with them hugging you or whatever it is. You get sick and tired of it. And some stars, they do not cover up their emotions and they're mean to fans. Look it up online.
Yeah.
Many stars, they get so sick of it and they're tired of being polite. They get really mean to fans.
Yeah.
And then there will probably be some kind of a backlash, some kind of a fan time. The fans will post over Twitter or social media that so-and-so, you think he's so cute and he's such a great singer, but he's mean.
Yeah. 好，所以这个其实在这里，这个Robin 还不错啊，就哎、
yeah.
可以跟你们多拍几张照。那刚刚这个 Karen 老师讲那个其实真的是这样子，就是很多人，很多名人啊，这个尤其是影视明星呢，他们其实红了之后，他们一天到晚有人找他们签名，要跟他们合照，他们可能会觉得很烦哈。所以你可能是第一次看到他们，你很兴奋，可是他们看到很多很多跟你一样的歌迷哈，那或者影迷，所以这个时候有的时候这些明星呢，他可能他的情绪就写在脸上啊，他可能不高兴啊，或者是脸色很难看啊什么的。
Or they just refuse and they say something mean.
Yeah, 或者是他讲一些这个啊很难听的话，就拒绝你啊。那这个时候呢，这个。歌迷影迷可能就会受伤啊，心里会受伤，那可能就会这个上网去，所以在网络上可以看到很多这种东西哈、啊。他会这个人他怎么这我是很喜欢他才去要他的签名啊，结果他跟我说你滚开，你不要烦我之类的啊。
I think the reason I thought of this so quickly is because not long ago I read a post by somebody, a friend of a friend on Facebook, who said that they ran into John Wayne in a restaurant. I think it was in Arizona or somewhere, and that's how he reacted.He cursed them and said something extremely rude. And John Wayne, he's so famous. You know, we think, wow, he's a cowboy hero. But in person, excuse me, he's already gone, but I believe this is the truth. He was really rude to a fan asking for the autograph, for his autograph.
Yeah, yeah. 好，所以这个Karen 老师举了一个实际的例子哈，这个他的朋友哈，
朋友的朋友
哈，反正碰到。这个 John Wayne 好上去跟他讲，很兴奋，结果呢，对方呢这个非常粗鲁的哈，或者口气不好的啊，就
拒绝
的。那、
yeah. I think it was to the friend's mother.
Wow.
Yeah.
我觉得其实最简单的办法就是你不要迷一个人迷到什么程度。我觉得那个名人他也是个人啊，而且我事实上我觉得啦，很多人他 they don't deserve that fame 啊，所以
absolutely，
所以你
their looks deserve it.
Maybe,
their、
yeah.
looks, and their looks are often manufactured. If you see them without their makeup and their fancy clothes, you wouldn't even turn your head on the street to look at them.
Yeah, 所以尤其现在很多所谓的网红啊或怎么样，那你看他网络上那个长那个样子，其实我想大家都知道，那可能是修图或怎么样结果。然后影视明星呢，他们也没有不值得你去好像看到那种真的是啊非常崇拜的偶像一样去对他好什么，我觉得其实是不需要了。
Our brain plays a trick on us. They believe that if somebody has a beautiful exterior, our brain decides, well, since the outside is so beautiful, 应该是里外一致
Yeah.
Then the inside must be beautiful too. Our brain plays that trick on us all the time.
哦，对，那这个也是人性嘛。我们的头脑常常会骗我们。啊，我们头脑很容易看到一个外表不错的东西，就会告诉你说它里面一定也很好。
And we see people who look really plain, so we pay no attention to them.But they may have some treasures inside that we're not even imagining. Maybe something that we are really interested in.
Yeah.
But we don't give them a second look because our brain says somebody so plain is probably kind of boring.
Yeah. 那如果外表不怎么出众的话，我们头脑可能就会觉得说啊，这个大概没什么了。那所以各位，人不可貌相。我从小都听到这句话啊，可是后来现在越来越觉得真的是人不可貌相。
When you're older, you finally overcome that trick your brain plays on you sometimes.
Yeah, 真的。然后你因为你有太多的经验会告诉你说，这个人看起来金玉其外，
yeah.
啊，看起来人模人样的啊，他事实上他会做的事情是你没有办法想象的。那反而是有我这个遇到过几个外表实在是不怎么样，可是你跟他熟了之后就发现。他是个很温暖很 nice 的人
很迷人的人
对啊而且 很有内涵、
right.
对那这样子的话你就会了解到真的人是不可貌相所以千万不要被 某些名人的这个外表骗了，不要啊，他长得这么可爱啊，那其实背后到底怎么样，你其实不知道。
They're usually manufactured.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so let's move on to the next section, which is 动动脑. And here we're going to pick out the elements or decide on the elements that are going to go into our composition. First of all, is our topic and also our title, which you've already looked at. It's too good to be true. And this is a really useful expression. And you will often see it in a context like this. If something looks like it's too good to be true, it probably is.
嗯哼，好，所以呢，这句话很有趣。说某如果有什么事情看起来好像是好的过分了，怎么会有这么好的事情呢？
好到不可能是真的。
Yeah, 那后面就 it probably is, 就是它真的是太好了，不会发生。
Right.
Yeah.
And that is really true. If anything looks too good to be true, it probably is not true. There are probably very few exceptions.
Yeah, 所以像这句话我觉得各位可以记起来。If something looks too good to be true, it probably is. 它有可能真的就是它不是真的。那所以你要诈骗集团很多时候也是这样子。
Yeah.
他跟你说啊你中突然之例如说在你突然之间收到一个 email 说啊恭喜你中了100万。那我什么都我也没去抽奖你们刚刚你跟我讲中了100万。啊那就有问题。或者就算你去抽奖你中了100万你要去找那个主办单位而不是说啊人家跟你说你中了100万你就怎样怎样。Yeah.
Somebody cultivated me over the telephone with one of those many, many years ago.
Oh.
And they said, make sure that you watch television at a certain time tomorrow because we're going to hold a drawing and we have a feeling that you might win. So they called me the next day and they said, you won. And they said, you were supposed to watch the TV show and you're supposed to call. I said, I don't have a TV.
Yeah.
And then they just dial it. I don't have a TV and I didn't watch. And I said, 后来他说，哎，可是你中奖了，怎样的？ I said, 我没兴趣。And they said, 你不能说你没兴趣。That's what they said to me. And then you can hear.
Yeah, 那有问题了。所以这个Karen 老师也碰过这种诈骗集
团。Many years ago.
很多年前。所以我们大概每个人对诈骗集团都有类似的经验。那我觉得真的 if something is too good, 给这句话英文你把它记起来，就碰到这种事情就没有这么好的事情了、啊，或者是别人跟你讲说，哎，这个跟你联络说，你妈妈以前这个借我一笔钱啊，我现在要还你啊，啊什么的，
And be careful because maybe you're very 孝顺 as soon as you hear mama, then you believe anything they say.
Yeah, 所以要小心。
So if it sounds too good to be true, or if it looks too good to be true, it probably is. And our time and place are on holiday in London, a wax figure museum. Now, first of all, on holiday in London, that is British English. You're in London on vacation is American English. Holiday is 度假 in British English. Holiday in American is usually 节日. And a wax figure museum, I guess they have branches. There is not just one. Madame Tussauds, I think there is more than one. But as soon as you see a wax figure museum, most people think of Madame Tussauds.
Yeah, 我们常常想到就是这个杜莎夫人这个蜡像馆啊，这个很有名的。
Have you been there?
No.
You should go. That's worth going to. All right, and our characters are Amy and Tina and Robin Chan.
好，那我们的人物就是 Amy, Tina, 还有 Robin Chan.
Our introductory sentence, now we're moving on to our main outline here, 写作大纲。For our introductory sentence, we can write, while on holiday in London, Amy and Tina decided to visit Madame Tussauds, a famous wax museum.
好，所以当他们在伦敦度假的时候呢，他们决定要去这个杜莎夫人蜡像馆看一看。那他后面这里同位格告诉你，这个Madame Tussauds 就是一个 a famous wax museum, 一个蜡像馆的博物馆。
I would dare say the most famous wax museum in the world.
有可能，可能是全世界最有名的蜡像馆。
For picture one, we can write, the museum was filled with wax figures of many great celebrities.
好，那这个博物馆呢，里面 was filled with, 里面有好多好多的wax figures, 就是蜡像。是谁的蜡像呢 ?Of many great celebrities, 一些很伟大的或者是很有名的名人的蜡像。
And it is kind of creepy because sometimes you can't tell the difference. And sometimes a real person will get up. I had that experience. It was just a tourist who was dressed really nicely, could have been a wax figure. But actually it was a real person. Yeah, and vice versa. So you will also see some of the wax figures that really look true to life. So it's easy to get confused. In addition, they have very clever lighting. Because they play with light and shadow to make the figures look even more lifelike.
所以他们不但是用蜡像做出来的这个蜡像非常的逼真，他们也会 运用灯光效果
yeah.
这种产生明暗效果让这个人看起来更逼真
That's right. And the positions that they create the figure in, the positions look like something that maybe a painter wouldn't paint. It looks like an ordinary thing that somebody hanging around in the museum would do. So they're just very natural positions, like they're in the middle of a sentence or something.
那这些蜡像的姿势也通常都是很自然啊，所以你会觉得啊很自然，那就是一个人啊，然后看近之后，近看之后才发现，啊，搞了半天是蜡像。
So it can be kind of creepy.
Yeah.
Okay. Picture two, they excitedly took selfies in front of the wax figure of Robin Chan, which was in a cool pose while holding an electric guitar.
好，那他们 excitedly, 他们很兴奋的 took selfies, 就是自拍啊。那各位把它背起来啊 ,took 或者 take selfies, 就是自拍啊。那当然 ,selfies 表示他拍了不止一张了啊。
Mm-hmm.
那 in front of the wax figure, 啊，在这个Robin Chan 他的这个蜡像前面照自拍啊 ，which 就是指这个蜡像呢 ，was in a cool pose 啊，他的这个姿势呢，对，很性格啊啊 ，while holding an electric guitar， 他手上拿了一把电吉他啊，所以他拿着电吉他啊，那一副很帅的那个姿势摆出来。
And very often, it's with their legs spread wide apart and they're stooping down a little. I've never understood why people think that is so mean or so sexy. But they hold an electric guitar and they spread their legs way apart.
Yeah.
And then they're playing. What is attractive about spreading your legs apart while standing? I don't know.
很多时候呢，像这种这个像这类的这个图片照片，让我们会联想到可能是拿这个电吉他，然后可能脚张得开开的啊，然后这个弯着腰啊，在弹吉他，
yeah.
那很多人就会觉得哇，这个好性感哦，啊
，Yeah，
嗯
，And you can see that they're not very comfortable.
Yeah， 那其实你如果是弹吉他那个人，你应该感觉出来他不是很舒适。Yeah，
Okay， Picture three. When they were ready to snap another selfie with the wax figure, it had totally changed positions, which made both of them scream and realize that it was the real Robin Chan.
那他们准备好要再照一张相的时候 ，snap 在这里就是照相的意思啊。再照一个自拍啊，跟着这个蜡像自拍的时候，好，这个自拍完全改变了他的姿势。好，那这样子这件事情就
，yeah
吓死人啊！那让他们两个人都 scream， 他们都尖叫出来了啊！可是后来realize 他们就了解到说啊，搞了半天这是真的 Robin Chan。
All right, in our concluding sentence, the rock star signed his autograph for them and invited them to take more pictures with him. He was so nice.
Yeah, 替他们签名啊，各位注意到他怎么说呢 ？Signed his autograph for them 啊，而且呢还邀请他们再照更多的照片。
Right, and this makes me think of something similar, which I may have mentioned in a previous program, but this left a really deep impression on me. I went to Disney, and I happened to be for a delegation from China. And they showed us some of the exhibits. The one that I really remember, and maybe a lot of people remember, is they have a figure of Abraham Lincoln sitting down.
Oh.
And he gets up, he stands up and delivers a very moving speech. And he's our most beloved president. And I've been listening to a very long history of the Civil War and Abraham Lincoln. So I have more and more of a feeling for this man who once lived and once was the U.S. president, he was an amazing, amazing man. He had a really, really difficult job managing the Civil War. He was amazing, and he was an amazing writer. So we just have this great admiration for him. And then you see him slowly and very gracefully stand up. He was very, very tall in his, you know, well-known black suit and everything. And he delivered a message about peace and loving each other or something like that.I'm crying thinking about it. It is just so amazing. So you can get figures to be so lifelike. You know, it's almost hard to believe that they are not alive.
So it was a wax figure?
I don't know what it was made of, but it was similar.
Wow.
It was a figure created. I think it was a bit bigger than life and completely dressed in his authentic dress. And the whole scene of a room was like back in the 19th century.
Wow.
If you can go to Disneyland, this was the one in...
Which one?
In Los Angeles.
Oh, so this...
God, it was so amazing.
Karen 老师他真的他在讲这个时候我可以告诉他眼中真的是有泪。
Yeah.
对这个他非常感动所以他曾经看到在这个加州的这个迪士尼乐园看到那个一个林肯的像他这个 他本来是坐着的，可是他你可以看到他站起来，然后发表了一场演讲，
很短的，
很短的演讲，
可是那个内容就是很会给你很大的震撼，
很大的震撼。那个真的是很值得尊敬的一个美国总统啊。
Okay, all right. So we have finished the outline. We're going to move on to our model composition. While on holiday in London, Amy and Tina decided to visit Madame Tussauds, a famous wax museum. The museum was filled with wax figures of many great celebrities, including actor Tom Cruise, singer Madonna, and sports stars such as Michael Jordan. The thing that impressed the two young women from Taiwan the most was the figure of their idol, Asian rock star Robin Chan. The two tourists excitedly took selfies in front of the wax figure, which was in a cool pose while holding an electric guitar. After checking out the photos, Amy and Tina snapped more selfies with Robin Chan's likeness. As they went to take a look at the new pictures, they noticed the wax figure had totally changed positions. It was no longer holding the guitar, and instead it was smiling and making the peace sign with both hands. The ladies both screamed. Soon, though, they realized that the wax figure was actually the real Robin Chan. The rock star signed his autograph for them and invited them to take more pictures with him. Ah, what a surprising ending to the story, and what a nice outcome at the end, that somebody was actually a really nice person. All right, back to the beginning. While on holiday in London, Amy and Tina decided to visit Madame Tussauds, a famous wax museum. We've covered that. The museum was filled with wax figures of many great celebrities, including actor Tom Cruise, singer Madonna, and sports stars such as Michael Jordan.
好，那前半句我们看过的，好，那里有很多的名人啊，那在这里呢，就增加更多的细节啊，让它的内容更充实。这个细节的告诉你说，这些名人包括谁呢？包括这个啊 ，Tom Cruise 是演员啊，还有这个Madonna 是歌星。那各位注意到这个写法哈，它是 actor Tom Cruise 啊，它这个 actor 没有任何的冠词
，right？
呀、yeah, ，然后呢 ，singer 也是一样，没有任何的冠词，后面叫 Madonna 啊，然后呢 ，sports stars 为什么是？复数呢啊，因为他后面讲 such as 好多啊，例如啊，像的 Michael Jordan。
The thing that impressed the two young women from Taiwan the most was the figure of their idol, Asian rock star Robin Chan.
好，那这个地方各位注意这样的一个 chunk 啊 ，the thing that impressed 某人啊 was 或者 is 什么什么啊，那这里就 the things that impressed 某人是谁呢？就是 the two young women from Taiwan 来自台湾的这两位。这个年轻的女性啊，那最让他们觉得印象很深刻，觉得很棒的东西是什么呢 ？Was the figure of their idol 是他们的偶像的蜡像。那 idol 是谁呢？后面同逗点后面同一个告诉你，他们的 idol 他们的偶像就是亚洲的摇滚巨星啊 ，Robin Chan。
Mm-hmm. And I should mention that some of the figures are more convincing than others. Some of them look extremely lifelike. Some of them, you know, right away when you look at it that it's a fake.
啊、哦，那里的这个蜡像有的非常的逼真，但是有的你一看大概就觉得、这个是大概是假的。
The two tourists excitedly took selfies in front of the wax figure, which was in a cool pose while holding an electric guitar.
啊、哦，那这个句子我们刚刚看过，除了主词，它我们刚刚看到是 they， 那在这里就是把它讲出来 ，the two tourists.
After checking out the photos.Amy and Tina snapped more selfies with Robin Chan's likeness. And when you look at likeness, you're kind of smiling because you know what's coming.
Yeah, 那是 likeness 就是跟他很像的人，那或者是雕像，或者蜡像。Mm-hmm. 所以 checking out, 他们在看，他们看了一看他们照的照片，之后呢，他们继续照了更跟这个偶像拍了更多的照片。
As they went to take a look at the new pictures, they noticed the wax figure had totally changed positions.It was no longer holding the guitar, and instead it was smiling and making the peace sign with both hands.
好，那他们第二次又照了一轮照片之一轮自拍之后呢，他们也是一样，看看他们新照的照片。这个时候他们注意到 noticed 这个蜡像呢，完全改变了姿势啊，他已经不再拿着吉他了，而是呢 smiling 啊，在微笑着，然后呢，这个 making the peace sign 啊，那就是用两只手那个。各自弄出那个胜利的符号 V 型的符号、啊、那就来跟他们照相
The ladies both screamed
那两个人看到当然都尖叫啊吓死了
Soon though they realized that the wax figure was actually the real Robin Chan
不过他们很快就知道说原来这个是真的人在这里
The rock star signed his autograph for them and invited them to take more pictures with him.
这个句子我们刚刚看过了。
Maybe he's not quite that famous yet. He's still trying to build up his fame. Maybe that's why he's more tolerant. That's
Maybe.
A less kind way of thinking of it. Otherwise, he's just being nice.
Yeah.
That's it for today. Tune in next time. We'll see you then. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.